This lesson will cover the process on how to use Pipeline Manager to create the pipelines and how to place the piping components on pipeline. Let's start with routing some piping. In order to model the piping, go to the Standard Preferences dialog and create a new pipeline. Go to the OpenPlant Modeler workflow and choose the Piping Ribbon menu. Then, select the Standard Preferences command. When the Standard Preferences dialog appears, select the Pipeline section and choose New to create the new associations. At this point, the existing associations can be used as well. In this example, let's click on the Browse button below to select the existing pipeline that was created in the PID drawing and was stored the data on PlantSight. Once it is done, simply click OK button. Then the details of selected pipeline are now appeared from the Properties tab. Then click Save button to start routing the pipeline. To start routing the pipe, go to the Piping Ribbon menu and choose the Pipes command. Then select the Pipe button in the Component Gallery dialog. To match this pipe properties to the existing nozzle or pipeline spec, select that and it will show the nozzle that already set the size and spec of that particular line. In the prompts message, it states to enter the first point of this pipeline. The AccuDraw and AccuSnaps command can be used to toggle the compass by pressing the T button on a keyboard for a top plane, the F key for the front, and the S key for the side plane. In this example, either top or side plane can be used to direct the pipe to the proper direction. Then press the Enter key to lock the current axis. Then connect the pipe over and route to a similar distance as the parallel pipeline by using AccuSnap. It is possible to input a distance in the AccuDraw. In this case, enter 5500 to go 5500 millimeters out. Next, press the Enter key to lock the axis, then snap to the nozzle on the top of the horizontal vessel. Next step is to model some fitting and fitting makeup that is compatible with the PID drawing that was created in OpenPlant P&ID. Starting with the same process again in the Standard Preferences dialog, but this time, select the 60SWO600 pipeline. Then, go to the Piping Ribbon menu and choose Flanges button to start placing a weld neck flange. Select the flat face flange in the Pipe Spec dialog, then left-click to insert the flange onto the nozzle. And when they are completely connected, the software will automatically generate the appropriate bolts and gaskets. Continue to add another flange, but this time, select the raised face flange from the Spec List dialog. Next step is to add the valve by going to the Valves category and choose the Check Valve button. But before inserting the valve, don't forget to assign the tag first. To do so, click the Browse button and select a tag that matches with the PID drawing. Then, connect the check valve with another weld neck flange. Sometimes, changing the placement point from the main port to ruin port is needed to match the port size in order to connect the fitting port together. For example, to connect a reducer with a flange. Next, placing the 90-degree elbow and connect it together with a piece of pipe. in this case is inserting the gate valve to the pipe that was created previously. Select the valve tag from plant site and insert it using AccuDraw, then left-click to accept the valve placement and left-click again for the hand wheel orientation.